What I have here is the 4100 clay. It's named clay because, well, it's designed for printing actual clay. And it's not the first machine that WASP has developed in order to do this. There are other machines specifically designed for clay as well, but this one is special because this one has a heated system to print industrial clay, which is kind of cheating because it isn't actually really clay at all. Instead, it's a special polymer. It doesn't really need a whole lot of water. Instead, it just needs a heat source in order to become malleable. And then you can print something like this right here, which was a sample part for Honda, because this entire machine was developed in cooperation with Honda, and they printed the entire motorcycle out of clay as a prototype. So you can see there's actually quite the industrial application for this type of machine, but the difficulty for this type of clay is you have to heat it. That's why there's this entire separate unit right here and a heated hose to deliver the material to the print head. I'm cheating a little bit and checking my notes because I want to tell you the correct numbers instead of any I made up. It has a print volume of 400 by 450 millimeters, and the nozzle diameters can be either 4 millimeters, 6 or 8 millimeters, with a layer resolution between 1 and 3 millimeters. So you can see it can actually print quite quickly. The print speed can go all the way up to 150 millimeters per second. And with this clay, it's so cool because once that prototype is finished, you just take the clay, stuff it back inside the print tank, and you print the next prototype for the next model. So I think there's actually quite a lot of really cool applications that you can do with this printer specifically. And many, many companies, especially in prototyping, should have a closer look at this machine. It's still in the development phase, so we can't say exactly when it releases or what the price point will be. But I think it's already quite clear that it is a really exciting machine and that we're all looking forward to seeing it in action.